G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. As you know, I like figures and I like a little bit of sci-fi, so when you get a little figure and a bit of sci-fi together, gets me excited. Now, also I have to say about these sort of, I've done a couple of these little, well, I haven't done too many of the front 46 kits, but the modern armies in miniatures, MAME or whatever you call them, a lot of these kits are 3D printed. Well, I think quite a fair few of them are anyway. And this one here is in 135 scale, I believe. And it's your whatever it is, Mantis, Os A, dot A, whatever you want to call it. And if you have been watching my channel for a while, you'll know I love, my mechs. I love things like Matt the Mad Cat, or the Timberwolf, or the Vulture, or the Mad Dog, and Ed 209, and all the other ones I've done, Industrial Mechanica type, little, I think done all mech on theirs, and lots in the playlist, guys. Lots in the playlist if you have a look. But this one, I just really like the design of it. But I'll tell you what, and I'll be upfront with you, I don't like the price of these things. If you get online, they're not cheap. They're probably, for me, I think they could be, I don't know, I was sort of thinking about it before I did this video, I sort of traded this for something else, so it wasn't too bad. But when I look at online and actually looked at the price before I do the review, these can be anywhere up to, 200, I said it, $200 Australian, and that's kind of like before postage or something like that. Absolute crazy price. So do I think it's worth that? No, I don't. But do I like it? Yes, I do. So I was adding it up and thinking, oh, you get a resin figure or whatever. And I thought, what are they worth? About $20, $25 these days. And then I was adding up, these are sort of the metal barrels that you get, in the German 222s or anything. And I was thinking, what are they? $10 around, say $10, $15, say $30. So with the figure and those, say $50 for the barrels and the figure. So then you're paying, $150. For the rest of this sort of mech. And don't get me wrong, it's lovely, but it's tiny. It's tiny when you think about him being a 135 scale figure. So as much as I love these kits, I think that, obviously I don't know how much it costs to produce, but as a modeler and buying models for a lot of years, I find this kit very expensive for what it is. But in saying that, I absolutely love the design, which is why I picked it up. And let's take a quick look. Came with a lot of packaging, but this is how it comes. Each part, I had a lot of, paper packaging inside, little streamer things that it comes with. But this, environmentally friendly, I don't know. But if you like Ziploc bags, you might be pleasantly. So every part comes in its own zip. Look at that little thing there, that little thing here. Is in its own Ziploc bag. So every part comes in its own Ziploc bag. So if you wanted to collect things or put, I use Ziploc bags. So I quite like, I think this is ridiculous, but I like having them because if I ever want to do any, if I get Alpine Miniatures heads, how I put them in some Ziploc bags or having an idea and I'll put parts in the Ziploc bags to, keep them all together. So I quite like that. As I was saying before, and he's even got the little, that's what I was saying. I mean, these aren't, these are master model little barrels, metal barrels. So I'm going to zoom those in for you. And they're, they're really nice. No complaints about them at all. You've got the holes drilled out in there, if you can see that. And no complaints about that at all. And I also believe, I'll show you a few of the parts. I'm going to show you the instructions so you get a bit of a gist of that. But I was trying to find, here it is here, that took me forever. This one's a little bit bent, but I just can bend that back. So you actually get like a little metal or brass antenna with it as well. So there's a couple of metal parts. One thing that did really impress me about this kit was the actual instructions. They have done really nicely, very clear, and they do it in like a bit of a picture or part form if you like. And I really, really like that. I'll do a bit of a close-up of the actual little kit here for you. And as I've said before, I'm just a sucker with something with a figure in it. And you know, I do like my mech. So as I said before, absolutely love the look of this thing. It's a nice picture of the back there. If you like your little mechs, here's your little box art thing. Nice that they give you, they spend a bit of time, you know, with the actual instructions and the box art. And this picture here looks lovely. It just looks lovely to me anyway. So I like the little tree in the background, give you a little bit of height, and you get the little tree that it sort of stands on like that. And you can sort of glue it, you know, it can turn, parts can turn and move a little bit, but you know, obviously you can, if you like a certain position like this, if you're going to put that there, you'd obviously probably glue it in place. Another nice thing they do, and I'm sure they're doing this for quality assurance as well, but they go through and show you all the parts that you get in the kit. And they've obviously crossed them off to sort of prove that they've actually counted them as they put them in. Hence why I think you get 700 million different Ziploc bags. And it goes down to 24 there. And it goes all the way up to 46 here with some extra handles there. And there's your little figure along there. And again, lovely little instruction booklet. Again with the parts, and as I was saying, very clear. I mean, there's not too many parts to the kit, so but as you can see, they sort of color in each part differently and show you sort of what I like is they show you the before and they show you the after picture of it. So that's quite nice. Sometimes, you know, they can show you something but you're not exactly sure how that part looks, so to actually show you it connecting in the after. And the amazing thing is with that, and it's such a delight compared to like a Dragon Models kit, they go through and show you that every part of the actual kit. And obviously, you know, there's not that many parts to it, but as you can see there to there, it's really nice. It's a really, I just wish these kits were cheaper, because I think they would just sell, you know, obviously everything's cheaper sells better, you know, more, you know, but I just think these would sell like absolute hotcakes. Absolutely beautiful instructions. I think I've picked up one of their kits before, and I just had forgotten about this sort of the way they do their instructions. As you can see, the barrel going in there, and they normally do it for even left and right, which is quite amazing. You normally, most of the parts are similar, you think they just do it for one, but they go through and do it on the left and right side. Even attach it, but I quickly had a real quick squeeze through the instructions. And actually, you can buy this figure separately, which is funny enough, because I actually did pick this figure up separately before this kit came out, I think. And because I just quite the look of him and thought I could use him for something else. And here he is again. They give him to you in this kit. The only thing I probably, I don't know, if you're not a big flesh painter, I think it probably would have been nice if they'd given him full length arms in clothing, because as you can see here, his sort of uniform stops up the top here, and then you've got flesh to go down there. So if you're not a real big fan of flesh painting, unless you're a figure painter, that might suck a little bit. But if you're lazy, you could probably just paint it in black and his sleeves, and just pretend he's got sleeves on or something like that. Pretty go easily goes together around there, and just, you know, the little, I mean, look at this here. Almost just looks like a little spaceship on its own. Put a couple of little wings on that. Oh, I think of some silly things sometimes. There you go. It's a bit poseable there. I know the man's 135 scale, but I just wish they'd build these. I mean, not for the price, obviously, but I just wish they'd build some bigger mechs like this for 135 scale pilots. A bit like my Gunther that I did, if you've seen that video of my Gunther from Dusk Models. I sort of modified that a bit. A lot bigger than this kit. But absolutely, I'll just show you the, I really liked his helmet. That's a bit of a suck. And even just the little grills at the back here. I don't think, that's not photo etched. That's just printed, if you're wondering. But it's nice how they've given you the, sort of reminds me for some reason of the AT-ST from Star Wars, you know, the whole log thing, slipping over it. The foot for the, and they've sort of got the bark sort of breaking or something on each side of the foot bending over. But I mean, look at the cockpit here. No decals for the cockpit, I don't believe. But you know, with Red Fox and all those people building out those nice little decals now for cockpits, I'm sure you'd be able to mod some of those to fit into these little holes and stuff like that. Your old little 222 looks like light and almost bull bar there, or whatever you want to call it, guard. Really like how they give you that back picture as well. What a cool little mech with a big price tag. Okay, I'm not sure where my video, how long I've been talking for, so this might be the end of this part of the video, and then I'll post the part, just a quick shot of some of the parts in my next video if this has gone for too long. So thanks a lot for watching. I'll catch you later.